Welcome to Firehouse Park here in Brooklyn Center, the home field of the Brooklyn Center Centaurs for high school softball, our spring opener on 12 sports. It's the Breck Mustangs and the Brooklyn Center Centaurs. Hi, I'm Jay Wilcox along with Jim Feldman. And Brooklyn Center has gotten one game in so far and a 1-0 start as they beat Minneapolis Edison 7-5. For Breck, not only is it their first game, it's their return to varsity softball after a few years of not having a varsity team, just playing at the JV level. So kind of a new beginning, I guess, here for Breck in a lot of ways, Jim. And they have not even been outside on a field yet. So we'll have to see how things shape up for them in this first game.
I know a lot of the schools are running into the same problem with not being able to get outdoors yet. But it's just good to be out. It's a nice sunny day today. It's a little bit chilly. The wind's blowing pretty good. But outdoor softball, spring in Minnesota. I love it.
That's all part of it, dealing with the elements, too. So Miranda Grangruth is warming up. She is the starting pitcher, a junior for Brooklyn Center. They intend to probably use another pitcher today as well. It sounds like Sandy Thompson, and we'll see how that break down throughout the game. But at least the plan to start is that they'll use each of them a little bit here today. Brack getting set to bat here in this first inning, and the lineup for Marcus Harris and the Mustangs look like this. Malicia Stevenson, the catcher, who's a real good one, leading it off. And Olivia Tendabout hitting second, playing shortstop. Michaela Stevenson, the pitcher, hits third. Addison Gleekel, the second baseman, hits fourth, followed by Kaylin Garrett at third. Kylie Paw in center. Isabel Saraju playing in left field. Jocelyn Garrett playing at first base, and Mariam Ali in right field. So here's Malicia Stevenson stepping in to lead things off here for Breck in the top of the first. And that pitch taken down low, and Coach Harris saying that Malicia, clearly their best player and their leader. So they'll get a chance to try and get her on early. Pounding one down to the left side. Here's the throw across, and it is not in time. Stevenson will beat it out for an infield hit. Fielded pretty cleanly.
Yeah, fielded cleanly. I mean, when the shortstop has to go to her right, the game of fast pitch softball is so quick, and there can be no hesitation whatsoever. But she got down the line real quickly and beat it out.
Back up the middle, and the throw to first is in time. And the runner will advance.
That was a good play by Gangruth. She knew right where she was going to go with the ball, which was over to first base, not even taking a look at the runner going to second.
So Olivia Tanatabout moves the runner over, grounds out herself, and now Michaela Stevenson, the Breck pitcher, steps in. Swing and a miss, and Stevenson thought about going, but will not try and advance.
Yeah, it'll be interesting to see how some of the strategies play out with a couple of fairly inexperienced teams playing.
Granger was up high with that one, and the runner going, the throw to third gets away, and Stevenson had that one stolen easily anyway.
Yeah, nicely backed up by both the shortstop and left fielder.
So Grangruth now going to try and concentrate on getting the hitter out here. As you see, she was going to be in there easily anyway, regardless of throw getting away. Pitch misses inside here to Michaela Stevenson. And that one stays up high from Grangruth.
You got two quick strikes on her, and you don't want to lose this batter. There you go.
And a rip and a miss. So she gets the strikeout. Stevenson down on strike, so two outs. And Addison Gleekel will be the hitter for Breck. First pitch hanging up high as you get a look at the defense here for Brooklyn Center.
Make sure she's back before you throw through there. I hope she may come home on your throw.
And a little chopper back and grabbed up. Grangerud able to flip to first and get Gleekel, and the Mustangs threaten but don't score in the first. No runs, one base hit, no errors, and they leave a runner at third. So Brack almost getting one across in the first but not quite able to do it. So Brooklyn Center and Sarah Senegar's team will get their first chance with the bats. As we said, they put up 7 runs in their first outing of the season, so they'll try and get something going early on. Sandy Thompson, the shortstop, will lead it off. Then it'll be Felicia Yang, the catcher, followed up by Deja Gibson at first base. Then Sierra Gambrell-Talley, the third baseman, will hit fourth. Then the pitcher, Miranda Grangruth, will hit in the 5 spot for BC. Molly Falness at second base, Desiree Swanson in center. Kayla Haugen, the left fielder, hits eighth. And the right fielder, Dorothy Lee, hitting in the 9 spot for Brooklyn Center.
Hey, so I'm gonna go back to that third out in the first inning, top of the first, if I could. And the play that Gangruth made was really nice, because she was able to just field it. And then even, you know, being a relatively inexperienced team, inexperienced player, she did the underhand toss, which is exactly the right play. If you have to stand up and make an overhand throw when you're close to your fielder, they tend to get away.
So look at the defensive alignment for Breck here. And obviously, like we said, have not been on a softball field this spring yet. They've been in their gym. So obviously that's a little bit of a transition, dealing with the wind, dealing with the sun, and dealing with some hops off the ground here. So they're going to be kind of a work in progress, both hitting and defensively here today. So see how that shapes up for them. Michaela Stevenson, second year in their program, just an eighth grader though, and you know, just really looking to get control, throw some strikes is what they're mainly aiming at, and you know, kind of work little by little toward working with some different pitches and things. But Sandy Thompson, the shortstop, steps in here to lead it off in the bottom of the first for Brooklyn Center. Has to jump out of the way of that one for ball one. And hits this one hard down the left field line. It's going to be extra bases for Thompson. She will have at least 2 here, and she will check in at second with a nice double to start the bottom of the first inning. Really jumped on that one, so Thompson.
And she gets to third on an overthrow coming in from the outfield.
All the way around she'll be. Pitch left up around the letters and just drilled it.
Yeah, she just got right on top of that one. Took a good stroke at it.
The catcher, Felicia Yang, now stepping in for Brooklyn Center, and obviously a great opportunity for them to score right off the bat, get a runner to third. So scored as a double and then an error to advance her to third.
It's a good block by the catcher.
Now the catcher-pitcher combination are sisters, so.
So they know each other's tendencies. I presume they've spent hours in the backyard throwing to each other.
Left up high there, Yang watches it go, so she's ahead in the count here quickly, 3-0. And ball 4, so Yang will draw a walk. Deja Gibson, the first baseman, will step in now for Brooklyn Center.
See if Yang takes off here and steals second right away. Create a little havoc on the bases.
That one's in the dirt, not going on the first one. Coach Harris was saying Alicia Stevenson throws really well, and they give her the green light to throw. He said, I just hope that all of our fielders are ready if she does. That one up the middle, the throw coming home, and now Thompson will retreat to third, so the bases will be loaded up. It wasn't a perfect throw, but enough to chase the runner back.
Yeah, and as long as Stevenson, the catcher, is able to get her glove on it and hang on to it, the runner had stopped, and there was not enough time to get going again.
So Gibson on a fielder's choice. Sierra Gambrill Talley will be the hitter now for Brooklyn Center and looks at ball one up high. Obviously now force out at any spot here for the Mustangs. Helps out a little defensively. Pitches in the dirt and Thompson's going to score. Everybody will move up. And it is now 1-0 Brooklyn Center as Sandy Thompson scores on the wild pitch. Yang moves to third, Gibson to second.
And having first base open now not only removes the force that if you get to a drop third strike situation, you've got to make the throw to get the out.
Back up the middle, that one will be through for a base hit. Another run scores on the play. And so Sierra Gambrill Talley drives in a run with an RBI single there for Brooklyn Center, and they go up 2-0 as Yang comes in to score. Runners now at the corners for BC, and Miranda Grangruth, the pitcher, hits. Takes the first one down low. Throw to third, not caught cleanly. She was going to be back in easily anyway there.
That's one of those throws you always question why a catcher would make it, because the runner was, you know, maybe two steps off of the base.
Swing and a miss there as Grangruth was out front of that one. And taps this one foul. And driven foul down the left field line.
I thought I'd be safe parking down there.
Obviously Stevenson doesn't throw very hard. Takes a little bit, you know, she's out front of that one. A little bit of an adjustment a lot of times, but they've hit the ball pretty well here so far.
Ooh, that looked good.
Close one
just
there.
Inside.
Yep, takes it for a ball. So full count here now as Grangruth battling with Stevenson. Hit hard. That's a fair ball down the left field line. A run scores, makes it 3-0 Brooklyn Center as Gambrill Talley hangs on at second base and Gibson in to score. Well, you like to see, too, that for Brooklyn Center, I mean, they're getting these runs on legitimate hits, too.
Oh, sometimes they're solid hits.
Yeah, you're seeing sometimes, you know, the other team might be throwing the ball around a little bit or whatever, but it hasn't really been that too much. It's been mostly solid hits.
It is, but the, you know, the Stevenson, the pitcher Stevenson is, you know, not that fast of a thrower. She's fairly accurate, too.
Pop up the middle, oh, and a nice running grab, and nearly got the double play. As a good job tracking that down by Tanata about there for Brack to get that first out. That was not that easy of a play.
No, it wasn't, and it was not high enough to be called an infield fly. Here she goes. You can see she gets a good jump on the ball right away. The runner on second base, being alert, gets back in time.
Desiree Swanson is the batter. Here's a throw down to first as Grangruth gets back in. So the center fielder Swanson will hit now for Brooklyn Center. One out, runners at first and second. Three runs already in for BC. Fouling that one away at the plate. in the dirt there. A nice block by Malisha Stevenson sliding over.
Yeah, Malisha shows very excellent technique and everything I've seen so far.
I'm going to throw back down to first again here. Takes that one up high for a ball. Three balls and a strike here to Swanson. And that one is in the dirt, and she will draw a walk to load them up. Second walk issued here by Michaela Stevenson. And Kayla Haugen will be the batter.
Going out, having a little chat, just settle your sister down, try and get find the strike zone consistently.
Leaves that one way up high.
It's really tough on the inexperienced pitchers that have to come in and pitch, particularly at the varsity level. You know, because all the eyes are on you. And
cut and a miss. Now 2-1. And fouling that one back. It was in on the hands a little bit, so Stevenson battling back here to even the count up.
I'm just throwing the ball a little bit harder right now than she was earlier.
That one way up high and away. So count running full, nowhere to put her here. Haugen trying to get on base here and keep this inning going here for the Centaurs, and she'll take ball four up high to walk in a run.
And those easy RBIs.
So Gambrel Talley will come in to score. And Dorothy Lee will be the batter now for Brooklyn Center. Still loaded up. Four runs in for Brooklyn Center. And still just one out. Slap foul down the first base side there by Lee. Oh, and that one hits Lee. So she will trot down to first base and another run comes in as Grangruth scores.
In baseball, there's a rule that you have to at least make an attempt to get out of the way, but in softball, there is no such rule. And so you get a lot of players that just stand there.
Sandy Thompson back up, and she hits this one well out to right field, a long drive, and it'll get to the fence. Nope, it is over,
it is
the,
over
fence.
The fence.
Home run and a grand slam
home
for
run.
Thompson. Big blast here as the rally continues for Brooklyn Center. Driving it deep to right field. Boy, she hit the ball harder first time up on a liner down the left field line. This time, just a high fly to right.
Yeah, I mean, the pitch was up and away, and she just went with where the pitch was thrown and hit it high, and there's a little bit of wind blowing out in that direction. Not that it needed much assistance from the wind.
Obviously, we've got the fence for the other field behind there, and that fooled me. I thought at first it had dropped in front of that. 9-0 lead now for Brooklyn Center as Yang takes that pitch. Yang drew a walk her first time up. Drives this one out to center, and it is going to get overhead and the extra bases here. Yang digging in and will hang on at second base with a double. I don't think there's much doubt the wind played a little bit of havoc there in center as Pa gave chase to that one.
Well, yeah, and if she's not used to playing the field, you know, the right-hand hitter hitting the ball a little bit to the right side, it's going to curve away from you. That was a tough play, but it was also a well-hit ball.
Gibson, that one over for a strike. She reached on the fielder's choice her first time up when they threw home to keep a runner from coming home. Came in to score. Takes that one inside. Pounded to short and not going to end up with a play. Throw the first two late. And so Gibson will reach on the air. Knocked it down but couldn't come up with it.
Yeah,
to not about.
Knocked it down but kept in front of her.
And she didn't really panic either and
no.
You know, get up and throw it away or anything, although probably would. Really didn't need to throw to first by that point because it was obvious she wasn't going to chance to get the runner. Gambrel Talley will be the batter here for Brooklyn Center. Still just one down. She had an RBI single and scored, I was going to say last inning, but it's still
the same inning.
And bottom of the first here.
Yeah, eight of the nine starters have already crossed the plate for Brooklyn Center.
Little tapper, this is going to be a tough play. Throw to first base is in time to get the out.
It was a good play. Garrett came in, barehanded the ball. You know, when the ball's going slow like that, that's the play you've got to make. Just pick it up, take your time, know who your runners are, and make a good throw, and get her out.
So Grangruth will be the hitter now with two outs. Runners at second and third for Brooklyn Center. Breck just trying to get out of this bottom of the first, which has been a tough one. And like I was mentioning earlier, I mean, sure, Stevenson doesn't throw particularly hard and is kind of learning on the job, but you still credit Brooklyn Center for hitting the ball. I've seen a lot of times where people have trouble hitting even a slower pitcher. That's a fair ball down the third baseline. One run is in. Throw coming to second and not in time. Just got in under the tag as Grangruth will wind up with a double. They held the second runner at third there.
Yeah, ball was right down the line. And the runner.
Molly Falnas knocking it down to second, and they get the out there. Good play by Leekle to get the out. However, it's a huge inning for Brooklyn Center. As they end up with 10 in the bottom of the first, we'll be back with our second inning here. Softball action on 12 Sports.
You watch Channel 12 at home. Why not on the go? Channel 12 is online at 12.tv. Watch on your phone, on your tablet. Channel 12 is your local source wherever you go. Just log on to 12.tv. Check out our videos, subscribe to our YouTube channel, follow us on Twitter, like us on Facebook, and even watch live events via live stream. So don't wait. Stay up to date with Channel 12 and 12.tv, your local source.
An eating disorder feels like having another person inside your head. It kind of built this wall around me.
The main thing that we needed was hope.
Your age, your gender, your ethnicity, eating disorders don't discriminate. They can strike anyone.
The National Eating Disorders Association has the information and resources to steer people and their families toward the road to recovery.
call or visit the NIDA website today for help and hope.
And we head to inning number two here on a sunny but very cool and windy afternoon at Brooklyn Center as the Centaurs leading Brack by a 10-0 score after one inning complete. Brack will have the 5-6-7 hitters Kaylin Garrett, Kylie Paw, and Isabel Saraju coming up in the second inning. They got one base runner on an infield hit in their half of the first before Brooklyn Center put 10 on the board, with the big highlight being that grand slam by Sandy Thompson.
Yeah, Thompson hit two well-hit balls in that same inning. It's a little bit unusual, but she took advantage of the situation.
Kaylin Garrett now stepping in here for Breck. She had a solid play on that slow roller to get them out of the inning. Also a basketball player at Breck. And fouling that one back out of play.
Yeah, those pitches up at the shoulders are both hard to lay off and they're also hard to hit.
Yeah, the ones that you can see so well, you feel like you're able to jump on. I think you just don't realize that more often than not, you're gonna hit the bottom of the ball if you hit it at all. Yeah. And there's a base hit down the third baseline. Strong hit to start this inning for Brex, Kaylin Garrett. And so a leadoff hitter aboard for the Mustangs, and Kylie Paw will hit.
Yeah, she hit it right between the third baseman and the line.
Pitch is low, runner is going. Here's the throw down, not in time. And so a stolen base for Garrett. It gets away, but she was in easily anyway.
Yeah, Young's got a nice strong arm. She takes a couple of extra steps to get rid of the ball. She's done that on both stolen base attempts.
Looks at a ball there. Inside there.
Caught the corner. It was one of those that he started a little bit inside and let the wind bring it back.
Yep. So 3-1 count now to Paw. And in the third, runner going to third, Garrett. Throw not in time, and so it's a walk to Paw. And a wild pitch advancing Garrett over to third, and so Saraju will step in here for Breck.
So Brooklyn Center handles the first and third situation. Runner goes.
Pitches a strike and they'll throw right back. Rangerud stopping it there. And so runners at second and third now for the Mustangs.
As well played by the Mustangs to not stray off the third base on that throw down.
Grounder to short. They're going to go to first with it and get the out there. Run will score as Garrett comes in. Saraju gets an RBI out of it, but she is out 6-3, and especially when you've built this big early lead, that's definitely the right play there.
That is definitely the right play. I mean, you know, if it was late in the game, you might want to try and preserve a shutout, but get the outs right now.
And Garrett seemed like a pretty, good aggressive base runner. We could see in that picture there that she was already almost home. They had no chance at her anyway.
No chance.
So here's Jocelyn Garrett now batting for Breck. Takes that one inside.
Yeah, when you're playing in the infield, you've got to have a little mental checklist of where you can go depending on how the ball's hit. And that ball was, not hit nearly hard enough to be able to come home.
Yeah, Garrett will draw a walk.
We should have pointed out that was Breck's first run in, what, 3 years?
Yeah, I think it was the fourth year or so. So, yeah, that's true there. Yeah, got to take little steps at a time here. And I'm talking with Coach Harris about it, and it felt like in some ways, playing the JV schedule was where they needed to be. But you kind of said, too, to have a little credibility with some of the people within their school and everything, in terms of some of the girls were, he felt maybe they were hearing that they were less likely to come out if it wasn't going to be a varsity sport, so made the move back up. So Miriam Ali, the hitter, with runners now at second and third for Brack, and that one almost hit her.
And the real key in building a program is getting the elementary school kids excited about playing softball. And it's a lot easier to do when you've got a varsity team than with just a JV team.
And obviously Brack in a situation as a private school where they don't have a set like community feeder program to deal with too. So they're struggling with numbers in the lower ages. Not much. He said basically this is our program, what you're going to see on the field here today. There aren't other levels or anything. So Rangruth trying to battle back and get the out here. Ali fights it off and stays alive. Oof, and a Dust Bowl type storm comes blowing through here. Ali stepping out, nice, wisely so, because yes. It was pretty tough to see.
Yeah, it's a good thing that didn't happen right as the pitch was being delivered.
In the dirt there, nice stop by Yang.
Yeah, Yang showing good technique behind the plate as well. So it really helps keep the game moving along when your catchers are able to feel all the pitches that aren't quite right down the middle.
And a rip and a miss, and Miriam Ali strikes out, so out number two in the books. Good battle there by Grangruth. Sometimes those make you feel even better when you have to fight back like that, and it's a tough at bat and everything. Malisha Stevenson stepping in now for Brack. Driving it down to short. Throw across is just in time to get the out. Stevenson really hustling down the line. The Mustangs done in the second inning. They do come up with their one run, their first run here on one base hit, and they'll leave a couple. So we go to the bottom of the second inning. It is 10-1 Brooklyn Center.
Thousands of teens in foster care who don't need perfection. They need you.
Don't look at me. Your hair's a bit frizzy today.
Aww. You should pick that up.
Oh, you're such a dork.
Loser.
Here, let me help you with that. Oops.
Every day, kids witness bullying.
Oh, look. Your crush is looking at you.
Poor you.
They want to help, but don't know how.
See, no one here's gonna help you, because no one
teach your kids
you.
How to be more than a bystander. Visit stopbullying.gov.
Welcome back here to Brooklyn Center, our season opener for high school spring sports on 12 sports here in 2016, as Brooklyn Center put up 10 in the bottom of the first inning. They lead Breck by a 10-1 score as the Centaurs get set to hit in the second. They'll have the bottom third of their order, Swanson, Haugen, and Lee, who all batted, obviously, once as they batted around and then some in that first inning. All of them reached base, none of them on a hit. It went walk, walk, and hit by pitch. So Swanson steps in. She walked and scored last inning in her first at bat. And looks at ball one.
I'm sure those batters from Brooklyn Center that walked or got hit in the first inning, they're looking to join the hit parade. Because hitting is always contagious, and there have been some good raps by these Brooklyn Center players.
That one is over the inside corner, so 2-1. Three balls and a strike. Cut and a miss that time, and now count running full. Oops, just a bit high there. Stevenson, the catcher Stevenson, jumping out to grab that one. And so Swanson will walk for the second time. And Kayla Haugen will be the batter. That one skips in. Nice stop by Stevenson. Alicia Stevenson back there. Throw getting away at first, but Swanson not able to advance.
Yeah, the previous pitch was one where she could have taken a throw down to first because the ball's in the dirt and the runner made a little break towards second.
Little tapper, and it's a foul ball. Ball started out in fair territory with a lot of spin on it. Gets across the line, and Stevenson alertly picking it up to make sure it didn't make its way back into fair territory there.
Well, plus these batters facing the slower pitching are way up in front of the box, and so they're standing well in fair territory to begin with.
It'll pop up here. Might be a tough chance. It's going to drop in. And everyone will be safe as Swanson had to hold up, obviously, to see if it might be caught. And it will drop in for a base hit there, and Swanson able to make it to second. Little hesitation there.
A little bit, and then could have been the sun gun was in the way, too. You know, it certainly didn't make that an easy play for Glico out there in right.
That one's over for a strike here to Dorothy Lee, who was hit by a pitch her first time through. Wraps it to second. Gleekel up with it, and the throw to first is low, and everyone will be safe. Just kind of short-armed that one a little bit, and Lee reaches on the error. Looked like they were going to get an out on it and just left this ball short.
Yeah, it's like she changed her mind in the middle of the throw from, I'm going to throw a really nice, hard throw, and, well, I don't need to throw it that hard.
Yeah. So Breck, obviously they're kind of learning, and but generally hadn't been making too many big mistakes, and that one was probably the first, real glaring one. Sandy Thompson, chance for another grand slam like she had last time. That one will get through, and the runners are going to hold up. Maybe as much as anything to say, we want to leave them all out there for Sandy. And also with this big of a lead, even though it is early in the game, you kind of maybe ease up a little bit. But Thompson, yes, hit a rope for a double in the first inning and then homered to right field with the bases full in the second, or in her second at bat of the first inning, I should say, and fouls that one back out of play.
She's looking to hit the ball, that's for sure.
Reach for that one and pops it back up into the bleachers.
Let's go, Sandy.
was a bit she couldn't really do much with other than what she did, just pop it foul.
Yeah, sometimes you're glad that those end up going foul because she knew she didn't really hit it well. That one bouncing in. Count is full here to Thompson. Bases loaded, nobody out in the second. Trying to extend a 10-1 lead. And Thompson will not get a chance to swing the bat here, so they walk in a run.
It's 5 RBIs for the leadoff hitter.
Yeah, not a bad day so far. And we still got a little time to go. I mean, obviously we have the possibility of this game being shortened by a 10-run rule, but we're not, you know, not to that point yet. Obviously we're at 11-1. Liner by Yang, foul down the right field side. She hit a double last time up and walked the first time that she hit in the first inning. Little tapper. Stevenson's going to flip to the plate.
Beautiful.
And they safe at home.
Safe at home, and she missed the base. She was standing out in front of the base and didn't have her foot on it, the Stevenson, the catcher. It was a great play by the pitcher, Stevenson, to come in, scoop the ball. And you can see she's straddling the plate. Oh boy.
See, I thought
that was pretty close. That was closer than I thought.
I thought the umpire might have gotten confused whether it was a force play or not. And then at that point I think he couldn't change his mind. That was my read of it. Gibson now stepping in here for the Centaurs. And lining it out of play down the left field side. Gibson has been on twice, but not with base hits. She had a fielder's choice and then reached on an error. Stevenson, a nice block there. Smokes this one out to center field, and that one will be in for extra bases. Two runs will score at least, and this throw gets away a little bit, so two more runs in as Gibson pounds a double for Brooklyn Center.
That was just hit on a rope out to the center. The center fielder tracked it very nicely. Just couldn't quite get over there in time.
14-1 lead now for Brooklyn Center as Sierra Gambrell-Talley will step back in there. She's 1-for-2 at an RBI single and a ground out in that first inning. Big cut, but didn't get it. So three balls and a strike here to Sierra.
You know, watching Breck play defense, even though they're inexperience, they appear to be very well coached in terms of where they're supposed to go on every play and what they're supposed to do. You know, it takes time to build the skills, but you can work the mental part of the game, and they seem to be doing that as well as anybody.
Yeah, Coach Harris was talking about that, you know, working a lot with the situational things. Where do we go in this, and where do we go in that? And he said, I hope they're getting it. Grangruth is the hitter. Little pop up and the nice running catch made there by shortstop Tanatabout. So first out and Fallness will hit. I thought off the bat this one might be a little bit of trouble, but she got there in pretty good order.
Yeah.
Fallness takes it for a ball. So Molly's due here. She's 0 for 2. The first time up was a little liner up the middle at the shortstop. Made a nice play on. Lifted to center. Coming on and will make the catch. And the runners did not tag up. Throw back to third is
in time.
Double play. So they get the two outs as a runner from third.
Lost track of how many outs there were.
Yeah, she just came running in. So a nice catch, and they get out of the inning, though. So Brooklyn Center does get four more in the second inning. They lead it by a score of 14-1 as we head to inning number three.
New dad took me on vacation. First, we went deep sea fishing.
Wow! I'm so proud of you, son.
And then we went on Thunder Shark.
That was awesome! Let's go again!
Three times. I gotta say, it was pretty cool.
You don't have to be perfect to be a perfect parent. Thousands of kids in foster care will take you just as you are.
Oh, not again.
30 million Americans will suffer from an eating disorder at some point in their lives. The National Eating Disorders Association has the information and resources to steer people and their families toward the road to recovery.
Hi, I work at the NIDA helpline. We have something called Click to Chat, which is a live chat with someone on the helpline, and they're really able to get support.
Call or visit the NIDA website today for help and hope.
A lot of offense for the home team so far. Brooklyn Center leading Brack by a score of 14-1 as we head to inning number three. And Brack will have the 2-3-4 hitters to start this inning as Grangruth completing her warm-up tosses here as Tanatabout, the shortstop, will step in to lead things off here for Brack. She's also a tennis player for the Mustangs and an exceptional visual artist is what notes we have on her side too. So well-rounded as a lot of the rec students turn out to be, it seems. Cutting
and
a miss
probably
at that
pretty
one.
Intelligent too. I mean, that's do a lot of good things over at rec academically. And
yeah, difficult school. They really prepare good college prep school. Tanatabout bounced one back to the pitcher last time. This time knocks it to third. It's juggled and she's gonna make it. So reaches on the air to start the third.
Yeah, hustle lob in the box. Used her speed to get down to first base.
Here's Michaela Stevenson, the Brack pitcher. She struck out her first time up. Back to Grangruth. She'll go to first and get the out. A very good jump down there by Tanatabout. That would have been a tough play to try and get her out. And again, with this margin, too, I think that's the safe play is the right one there for Brooklyn Center.
Yeah, she was off with the pitch. I mean, she was either a hit and run or a straight steal.
And here's Gleekel stepping in here. She bounced the pitcher her first time up. And right back again to Grangruth. She'll come up with it and fire to first to get the out. Tanatabout moves over to third, but Brooklyn Center getting a couple of quick outs after the error to start the inning, and Kaylin Garrett will hit now for Brack. Hits it to short, juggled, and gonna make it, so the run will score. As Tanatabout comes in, second error of the inning on the Centaurs, and Garrett aboard.
Yeah, she was in a nice position, fielded a little bit off of her left foot, but that's a play she'd come up with.
Kylie Pahu walked her first time up here for the Mustangs, so they get their second run of the game here and helped out by a couple of infield errors for the Centaurs. I think Thompson out there at short, he's probably thinking about getting another at bat, so she's maybe thinking through that. It's easy to do. There's a little dribbler and nice play by the pitcher. And so she gets an assist on all three outs here in the third. Brack done in inning number three. They get one run, no hits, a couple of BC errors, and one left. We go to the bottom of the third. Brooklyn Center leading at 14-2.
Sharing your passion starts with taking that first step. Take Will, for example. His first step was taking free TV classes at Northwest Community Television. He's learning production skills and now has access to cutting-edge equipment. He's working on local music productions, meeting new people, and gaining experience needed to produce his own show. Best of all, he's sharing his passion for music with others in his community. Share your passion. Visit nwct.org.
The average text takes your eyes off the road for nearly 5 seconds.
You watched him.
Sunny but windy and cool afternoon here to start the week as Brooklyn Center and Brack battle here in softball, and Brooklyn Center's dominated so far, leading at 14-2. They will hit here in the bottom of the third. The 7-8-9 hitters coming up for them. Desiree Swanson stepping in to lead it off against the pitcher Michaela Stevenson. Swanson has walked each of her first two plate appearances. And halfway to doing so again, as the first two are well out of the strike zone. Got that one in there, and Swanson fouls it away at the plate. There is strike two. Nice hit ball to right field. Could be a play at first, and the throw sails high. They were not going to get her anyway.
Not
going
to get her anyway. But it was a good heads up play by the right fielder to come in and try and get that out.
Hit this ball pretty solidly, and Ali coming in. You see right there, obviously not a very good throw, but she was at least alert to take a chance. Mm-hmm. Haugen popping it up, and Stevenson will make the catch. So one out, and Dorothy Lee will bat now for Brooklyn Center.
Yeah, Stevenson seems to be throwing the ball a little better each inning. The speed seems to be picking up a little bit. Just hanging right in there in the strike zone. Yeah, a lot of times for pitchers, especially inexperienced pitchers, when you try and throw strikes, your speed goes way down, and you're not more accurate.
Pounded to second, Glico up with it, and they flip to first is in time. So Swanson moves over to second, but Brack, this is a step forward this inning. They're getting a couple quick outs here. And now Sandy Thompson, who's been very difficult to get out here so far, obviously, a double and a grand slam and then a walk. See Gleekel again, a little some trouble with the throw, but good fielding play.
Well, that is a tough throw to make for a second baseman, you know, unless you're accustomed to making that throw, because what you really need to do is stay down on the ball rather than standing up. And then when you stay down, you kind of throw sidearm, and it takes a while to master that.
In the dirt, and Thompson skips out of the way of that one. Now, obviously, this early in the year, I'm sure they weren't dealing anything with scouting reports or anything like that, but I know after her first two at-bats, this pitcher remembers 22.
Right.
And she's been pitching carefully to her.
Yeah, I'm surprised the right fielder isn't playing a little deeper at this point.
And so was the catcher, because she was motioning her to move back just about as the pitch was about to come. And that one in the dirt for the second straight time now. Thompson will draw a walk. And you know she was eager to hit based, you know, on her last at-bat too, but those pitches were just not close enough to even think about swinging at. So Felicia Yang will bat.
And you've got to play a good team game. If someone's going to give you a walk, you know, you got to take it.
Late on that swing there, she eyed that one. Yang, a double, a walk, and reached on a fielder's choice. That one in the dirt and gets away, and both runners will move up. One of the few times, really, that Stevenson's been unable to block a ball, the older Stevenson and Malaysia, that is.
Yeah, and you know, she made a good attempt at that. Caught it with her chest protector, just deflected off sideways.
Three balls and a strike now to Yang. Gibson on deck here for Brooklyn Center. Yeah, a little pop up. Oh. Stevenson can't quite reach it.
Good hustle getting out of that box in a hurry. Getting out of the catcher's box in a hurry.
And another one, almost the same spot, except up a little bit higher, and it hits the backstop.
Yep, she didn't have quite enough time to climb the fence and get a glove on that one.
Again, pretty good read, though.
Yeah.
Knocks that one foul, kind of went after one up and out of the zone there. Yang a little laugh, knowing that sometimes you just really have it in your head that I'm going to protect, and you pretty much are going to swing at almost anything there.
Well, and that's actually not a bad philosophy if you can get your bat on the ball. You don't want to leave it up to the umpire, who might call one a strike, even if it's not in the zone.
Down low, and Yang will draw a walk. So now the bases are loaded up, and we're going to have a courtesy runner coming in. Again, Chalfin will come in to run for Yang, and Gibson is the hitter. So bases full here, two outs. Brooklyn Center, after putting up a total of 14 in the first two innings, hasn't scored yet in this inning. It looked like Brock might get out of it pretty quickly, but now bases full.
Well, she had that confidence against the bottom part of the order, and then the top of the order comes up, and you know, pitches like haven't been quite as good as they were to the bottom part of the order.
Up. Smokes this one into left field for a base hit. One run in, here comes run number two. And so Gibson, that was one of the hardest hit balls of the day right there. Sounded good off the bat, that's for sure.
Again, that pitch left up about the shoulders, and she just went up and tomahawked it out to left field.
So Sierra Gambrell-Talley will be the batter. She's at a single, a ground out and walk. So 3-0 count. And that'll be ball four as Sierra draws a walk for the second straight time. And Miranda Grandgruth, the pitcher, will hit for BC. Bases now loaded up. Couple runs in this inning, the 16-2 lead. Little tapper to third. And the throw will get away down at first base. And now two runs are going to score on the play as the runner coming into third was going to stay, but then everybody else was coming behind her, so pretty much had to go at that point. I don't think the ball ever did get all the way out of play.
No, it didn't get out of play. The ball was live the whole time around.
So a couple runs in on the air, and Molly Fowlis will be the hitter. Well, Molly's hit the ball pretty decent twice, but it hasn't gotten a hit yet. As she lined out to short up the middle and then hit that fly ball to center that turned into a double play, and she's now hit by this pitch.
Reload the bases.
Desiree Swanson will be the hitter. Marcus Harris coming out to visit with his pitcher right here. That one got her on the leg. Marcus Harris, of course, one of the all-time great athletes here at Brooklyn Center. Football was his primary sport, but also played basketball and baseball, and had a great career at the University of Wyoming as a wide receiver. Blitnikoff Award winner as the NCAA's Receiver of the Year, in fact. And came back and coached some at Brooklyn Center. He's been working at BRAC for a while now, too, and just one of the good guys that's been around for a long time and given back as a coach.
I know, that's always so nice to see, is the, you know, the coaches coming back and helping the kids and sharing their skills and talents.
When we walked up today, I said, "Welcome home." And yeah, you know, obviously a lot of ties here at Brooklyn Center. And in fact, the assistant coach for Brooklyn Center, Doug Darnell, was coached Marcus back in the day as a high school player. So here's Swanson, who's had a couple of walks and a single. Bases loaded up again for Brooklyn Center. Throw down to first. Ooh, and it looked like it might be in time, but wasn't sure where the runner was. Didn't get the tag down. Jocelyn Garrett, she made the catch, but she might have been up a little too far to really get that tag on. To third. Throw across and will get away. And a run will score. And again, we've got the same exact situation. The runners running into each other pretty much, and everybody's going to be safe.
Yeah, batter took off and bolted to second, and neither of the lead runners were going.
Score that as an error on the first baseman. I think that ball hit her in the glove. It wasn't a perfect throw, but it was good enough. And so E3 there, and Kayla Haugen will be the hitter. Haugen back to the pitcher. Stevenson will flip to first, and they get the out. So Brooklyn Center coming up in the inning with six more runs.
Yeah, I know, right?
And we have completed three here at Brooklyn Center. The Centaurs in command here at Firehouse Park.
Hey, did you buy something from some gaming site?
What do you mean?
Yeah, look, there's a bunch of different charges on here.
Do you think someone stole our credit card information?
I don't know. That site sounds familiar, though.
Yeah, isn't that the site that Billy's on all the time?
You don't think.
Billy!
Stop and think before you connect. Playing online is serious business. Visit dhs.gov/stopthinkconnect for tips on how to be safe online.
Sharing your passion starts with taking that first step. Take Lindsay, for example. Her first step was taking free TV classes at Northwest Community Television. Right away, she received professional training and now has the tools and skills necessary to produce her own show. She's turning dreams into realities right from her own home. And best of all, she's sharing her passion with members of her community and beyond. Share your passion. Visit nwct.org.
Brooklyn Center up 20-2 here as we head to inning number four. Breck will have the bottom third of their order coming up as they try and, obviously at this point they've fallen behind by enough that winning isn't probably terribly likely, but, you'd like to scratch away, get some good at-bats at least, and see what, if you can make some things happen.
Sure, and everybody likes to get up and hit and get on base and run and just get that experience of being out there and making a contribution.
So Roger drove in the first run for Brack. She grounded out to short, but brought a run home in that at bat in the second inning. So she will lead off inning number four here against Grant Ruth for Brooklyn Center, who's obviously had a solid outing for the Centaurs on the mound with a big lead, but also has just been around the strike zone for the most part, mm-hmm. has pitched well. In the last inning, the run they got was really two errors. It wasn't anything to do with not doing her job as the pitcher. Cut and a miss.
And she's getting in a groove too and throwing a little bit harder right now than she was earlier in the game. I mean, that's pretty typical when you're dealing with, I'll say, the less experienced pitchers.
Grounded to second, and they get the out there as handled cleanly and nicely there by the second baseman Faulness. So Jocelyn Garrett will hit. Did a nice job too of not hurrying things, realizing how much time she did have there.
Well, yeah, and Gibson took a look at possibly even making the play herself, and I'm not sure if they were communicating out there, but. Definitely backed off and let second baseman handle it.
Ball and a strike here. Jocelyn Garrett walked in her previous time to the plate back in the second. And hits this one well up the middle and will have herself a base hit. So Garrett didn't crush it, but got enough of it to drive it out over second base. And so a one-out hit here for Garrett for Breck, and Miriam Ali will be the batter for the Mustangs.
Again, taking the ball right where it was pitched. It's nice right up in the middle. Just slap it.
Cut and a miss. Runner is going, and the throw down to second by Yang too high, and Garrett in safely with a stolen base. Ali struck out her first time up. Takes a strike.
That's a good pitch.
And knocks it down to short. Thompson comes up throwing and gets the out there. Runner will move up.
Yeah, Thompson made a nice play in that ball. But she came up with it, saw that she had plenty of time to get to make a nice controlled throw over to first base and didn't rush it.
So Malisha Stevenson will hit now for Breck. and takes a strike there. She had an infield single to lead off the game, got as far as third, and then grounded out to shortstop her second time up. Again, she is considered their definite best player coming in.
You know, you were talking about earlier that you know, sometimes it's hard for the hitters to find their rhythm against a pitcher that's not throwing with blazing speed. And for most of the hitters, they're not used to seeing the fast pitcher. I think that
there's
this is the one exception.
Yeah, there's a liner to left field for a hit, and it will score a run. So Stevenson knocking one in as Garrett comes in to score. Probably, all things considered, Breck's best hit ball of the game right there. And solid RBI single.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, and that, you know, what I was saying is, you know, Stevenson's probably used to seeing faster pitching in her other playing experiences. And, you know, so for her, the timing is a little bit off.
Pitch taken for a strike. Stevenson in with a stolen base as Olivia Tanatabout is the hitter for Breck. Interesting, Breck is kind of playing it, you know, they're obviously the score, a big margin, you might say, why are they out there gambling? But they're trying to play it the way, you know, the way that you learn to play, be aggressive, even they're running even with this big deficit.
Oh yeah, and there's no, you know, there's not much downside to what they're doing. You know, on a play like that, if you don't get that big lead off of second base, you might not be able to take third on the pass ball or the wild pitch. You know, and so, you know, Stevenson's out there definitely, you know, setting an example for the rest of the players on, you know, what it's like to play aggressively.
Grandgruth trying to work out of this inning here. He's given up one run in the inning. It's a 3-1 count now to Tanatabout. And she will draw a walk. And the pitcher, Michaela Stevenson, will be the batter now with runners at the corners and two gone for Breck here in the fourth.
Good chance to help her own cause. Try and get chip away and get back in this game a little bit.
Little tapper, might be a tough play. Throw across is in time. So nice job to get out of the inning. Breck in the fourth gets one run on a couple of base hits, and they will leave one on base. So we go to the bottom of the fourth inning. Brooklyn Center still in command here at 20-3.
Don't look at me. Your hair's a bit frizzy today.
Aww.
You should pick that up.
Oh, you're such a dork.
Loser. Here, let me help you with that. Oops.
Every day, kids witness bullying.
Oh, look. Your crush is looking at you.
Poor you.
They want to help, but don't know how.
See, no one here's going to help you, because no one
Teach your
you.
Kids how to be more than a bystander. Visit stopbullying.gov.
30 million Americans will suffer from an eating disorder at some point in their lives. The National Eating Disorders Association has the information and resources to steer people and their families toward the road to recovery.
Hi, I work at the NIDA helpline. We have something called Click to Chat, which is a live chat with someone on the helpline, and they're really able to get support.
Call or visit the NIDA website today for help and hope.
Brooklyn Center started with a 10-run first and have continued to score here. They lead it 20-3 over Breck as we go to the bottom of the fourth inning. The 9-1 and 2 hitters coming up for Brooklyn Center as Dorothy Lee will lead things off for the Centaurs. And both of these teams really don't have much in the way of subs to speak of. So you might think, you know, with this margin that you'd be seeing a bunch of changes, but not necessarily the case because of, you know, just thin bench. DeBreck has made at least one change. Livia Reeder is out there now playing at second base. Lee a swing and a miss.
Yeah, and Brooklyn Center, it's got a couple of players that are injured and, you know, otherwise unavailable for this game.
I'm sorry, Svea McNally is out there playing at second for the Mustangs. Lee, a chopper down to short. Throw across is in time. Solid job there by Tanat about to get the out. And Sandy Thompson, who's been the hero of the day for Brooklyn Center. A double to left, a grand slam to right, and then perhaps as a result of those two, they've walked her the next two times.
Sandy's going, I want a pitch to hit. There it was.
And pops this one sky high.
That's a tough play.
Oh, and it's dropped. And so Thompson will reach. It was a good job to get to it, but then it just fell out of the glove.
Yeah, it kept on getting pushed a little bit by the wind, and you know, again, the spin on the ball. Pushing over that way. You know, with more experience, what you got to do is you got to know that that ball's going to be going over in that direction and get to
bunted it in the air there, and Stevenson throw to first is then dropped. They would have had a DP there. Thompson scrambling back, so Yang popping out on the bunt for out number two, and Deja Gibson will hit. Thompson asking for time to tie her shoe here, so Gibson, if it wasn't for Thompson's big day, would probably be considered the hitting star because she's hit back-to-back doubles and driven in four for the Centaurs, so another good day, or a good day for her too. Throw back down to first, and again, Stevenson has been alert and throwing the ball to the bases.
Yeah, a couple of times, you know, maybe ill-advised throws, but yeah, you got to keep your defense in the game.
Gibson, and that one's going to get off to not about tip of her glove and will fall in.
Yeah. Kind of turned Tanat about around a little bit. She was going for the ball.
Gambrel Talley will hit now. A single, a ground out, and a pair of walks for her. That one's in the dirt, and the runners are going to be able to move up. That one on the inside corner for a strike. Chopper up the middle. Tanat about coming up with it and throws to first to get the out. So for the first time, Brooklyn Center does not score in an inning. No runs, no hits, a couple of errors, and a couple left aboard here. So through four, Brooklyn Center leading at 20-3.
Wow, these are really good.
You act surprised. Practice makes perfect.
You don't have to be perfect to be a perfect parent. There are thousands of teens in foster care who don't need perfection. They need you.
Don't look at me. Your hair's a bit frizzy today.
Aww.
You should pick that up.
Oh, you're such a dork.
Loser.
Here, let me help you with that. Oops.
Every day, kids witness bullying.
Oh, look. Your crush is looking at you.
Poor you.
They want to help, but don't know how.
See, no one here is going to help you, because no one
Teach your kids
you.
How to be more than a bystander. Visit stopbullying.gov.
And welcome back here to Firehouse Park across the street from Brooklyn Center High School in Brooklyn Center. The Centaurs jumped on Breck early. They lead it 20-3. Breck reinstating varsity softball this year for the first time after a few years. So kind of taking their lumps here in this first one, but can only learn and grow from here. And
well, it was that first inning that really kind of set the tone for Brooklyn Center. And you know, after that, Breck has been playing a lot better, hanging their own.
Svea McNally, who came in at second base, will get her first at bat here to start the fifth. Cut and a miss for strike one. And there's strike two. And hits the ball fairly well, but Thompson able to get over and squeeze it for the out. So one gone, and Kaylin Garrett will be the batter now for Breck. Garrett had a single and then reached on an error, so she's been a tough out. Takes that one for a strike. Grandgrove's done a solid job out there for Brooklyn Center. I would, you know, kind of think that this one might give her some confidence that she's been around the plate for the most part.
Mm-hmm.
Fielded her position well, too. That one knocked it short. Thompson, a tough play, and the throw is wide, and Garrett will be aboard. You know, call that one an infield hit. It was a difficult chance on the backhand.
That was. Anytime the shortstop has to go in the hole, it's going to take an outstanding play to get a batter out in softball.
Okay, and the hitter now, we've got a pinch hitter. This is Livia Reeder pinch hitting for Breck.
That's good to get all the players in the game.
Runner is going, and the throw from Yang sailing down high. That was one of the few ones where the Breck runner hasn't gotten an especially good jump, and a good throw would have been able to get her, but.
Yeah, when you talk about getting a good jump and fast pitch, you're not allowed to leave the base until the ball leaves the pitcher's hand. And, it makes a big difference as to whether you're leaving, right on time or just a little bit late.
Ball four to Reeder, so she will draw a walk here with one out. And so now runners at first and second. And Siraju will step in for the Mustangs. 0 for 2, but drove in a run her first time. And down the line, but foul. Back up the middle, gets by the pitcher. Thompson, a quick flip to second. And they get the out there on the middle runner, if you will.
Yeah, it's always good to try and get the lead runners, or as you say, the middle runner. The throw is often shorter. And
so Jocelyn Garrett will be the hitter. She's going to be studying communications at Iowa State next year, one of the seniors on this Mustang squad. Runner is going. They'll throw to short, and just to see if they can catch him.
Again, both schools, are playing fundamentally pretty sound. They've worked on first and third place, both on offense and defense. And it's the third different one we've seen being used. Throw to short, throw back to the pitcher, fake throw.
Way up high that time. Two balls and a strike here to Jocelyn Garrett. Rangaruth trying to pin this one down and get out of the inning. Inside with that one, so three balls and a strike.
Well, she's got 7 runs to do it.
And that is ball 4. So Garrett will draw the walk. And so the base is now going to be loaded up for Wahinape Hunt, who will bat. Takes a pitch down low. Runner is coming. The flip to the plate, not in time, as Garrett able to score there on the wild pitch for Brack.
Coach taking the teaching moments here, you got to step out of the batter's box when there's a play at the plate. But there was no interference on that play, so it worked out okay.
There is a strike to Hunt. Hunt, a volleyball player as well for the Mustangs. Just fought that one off, foul ball. By the way, I want to pass along thanks to Shellen Johnson, the assistant coach for Brack and longtime head coach in this program, for compiling all the notes and getting the lineup over to me and everything. Really appreciate that. And there's a called third strike, and Hunt is caught looking to end it here for Brack in this fifth inning as they come up with one run, and that should be the game.
That should be the game. Yep.
And the 10-run rule is the Mustangs do get that one run in the fifth and one base hit. They will leave a couple, so teams now lining it up, and Brooklyn Center is going to
go
secure
to 2-0.
The victory. Yeah, 2-0 start for them, and they've scored a lot of runs in both of their games, too. So kind of set the tone, obviously, with that big 10-run first inning. And, you could see they just had a little more experience, a little more hitting in their team.
Yeah, and they were just taking advantage of the situation. They were putting good, very solid swings on the ball and, going with where the pitch was thrown and, playing good enough defense, good enough pitching, and pick up another win.
So the final is 20-4, Brooklyn Center. More softball later this week on 12 Sports as we'll be seeing Osseo Champlin Park and also Hopkins Wayzata. We hope you enjoyed this one, our season opener here, as Brooklyn Center beats Brack 20-4. For Jim Feldman and all of our crew, I'm Jay Wilcox. So long from Brooklyn Center.